Hello and welcome to this latest video in our series on the subject of trunking. Now, in previous videos, we've looked at the subject as a broad overview. We've looked at lids and end caps and how to fit those, and we've looked at the types of accessories. But in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to zoom in on some of those accessories and we're actually going to fit them. So what are we going to be covering in this video, Jake?
So we'll be looking at all the different accessories. We've spoke about them in a previous video, but now we're actually going to look at putting them together with the lid on and where we'd use them, show examples of what they look like in place.
Very nice. So specifically, we're going to take a deep dive into the 90s. Now, I know what you're thinking, the 90s were fantastic. It was Blur v Oasis. It was a heady time. I'm sure you remember it well, Jake.
I don't remember too much of the 90s.
Barely born.
93.
Okay. 93. Yeah. Make me feel old, Jake. Okay, so we're not talking about that kind of 90s though. We're talking about 90 degree bends in this episode. So we're going to bring the camera in and we're going to have a look at installing some of these prefabricated 90 degree bends.
So we'll take a look at the external 90 degree bend first, Joe. So we'll have a look at how this connects up.
Very good. So you've got the external 90 and that's just sliding in there. Now, notice you've got your lid still on your trunk in there, Jake. Is that right?
That's right, yeah. So it'll still slide on with the lid on. That's not a problem.
Very good. And we're using the pre-drilled holes in this case. So we were fortunate enough to have a piece of trunk in
that's
with
right,
the manufacturer's
yeah.
holes in, which makes life easier. That's good. And this is obviously a really nice, easy way of doing this. Now, we're going to create some content where we show you how to fabricate some of these bends. Obviously, you know, we understand that on-site prefabricated bends are the way to go because it's much quicker. But on those occasions when you find yourself on a Friday night absolutely at your wit's end because you're missing a 90 or an offset or something like that and you've got to get it in, then knowing how to do them by hand is just as essential as using the prefabricated ones. So there we go. And this side, of course, doesn't have any lid on, and that's still gone on there nice and easy, so you can install it either way, which is cool. Very good.
Yeah, so these are the holes that we drilled using our template.
Very good. Yeah, so again, big thanks to Eddie from Pegasus for demonstrating the idea of that template for us. And if you don't know what we're talking about, then please check out a previous video in this series where we showed you how to use that template. Very good. Okay, so we've got the corner fixed onto the two pieces of trunk in there. So what are we looking at now, Jake?
Yes, we'll look at how the lid goes on. And again, we spoke about this in a previous video. They just, it simply clips on. The little dimples just snap on, holding it in place.
Very nice. Now, this is quite an interesting demonstration here because we're seeing on the side that's got the lid on already, that just clips over the lid. So it's actually the lid that's holding, the lid on the straight piece of trunk in that's holding the lid on the bend in place there. So that's quite clever. And that's got that really securely there, Jake. That took a bit of a snap to get that on there. And of course, if we can just see the side that doesn't have the lid, you can see that that's still a little bit kind of loose there, isn't it? So that's still flapping in the wind a little bit. So we need that lid in place on the straight pieces of trunking in order to get the lid to sit on the prefabricated bend nicely. That's great. So that is the, which bend is this again, Jake?
So that's the external 90.
External 90. So again, you can imagine if this is perhaps a mezzanine roof or something like that on a factory unit or something like that, and we need to come off the top of that and drop down a wall, then that's where we'd be using this external 90 degree bend. So that's really nice and self-explanatory. That's great. Thanks for that, Jake. We'll move on to the next one.
So we'll take a look at the internal 90 now, Joe.
Very good. So again, we can clearly see a difference in this straight away from the last one because the lid is on the inside of the bend there, not on the outside, hence an internal 90.
Yeah, that's right. So all we've got to make sure of is that we get the opening the right way. It's not facing backwards.
Oh yeah, that's a good point, yeah.
And it simply just slots on, same as the previous bend.
Very good. So we just push those together.
Screw that into place now.
That's good. And one of the things I like about this particular trunking is you've got that kind of lip on the inside of the accessory there, which basically means that you're always going to push the trunking into the right sort of distance, which is really good. There we go. So that's two screws in. Thought you were going to cross-thread that one then, Jake, but you pulled it back like a star. Well done. Very good. Okay, so now we'll get the other piece of trunk in again, just slotted on. Really nice and neat. Again, some manufacturers, you may need to use a coupler to join these together, and there are some accessories from Atcor that do require that, and we'll look at those in a later video. But this one has the benefit of going inside, which has a couple of benefits, as we've seen. Very good. And the final one, just going in now. So again, fitting these is an absolute breeze, makes electricians' lives easier, which we're big fans of. And we've just got to get this last screw in, and we're all good. There we go. Happy days, very good. So again, we've got that internal bend, and the lid for that looks a little bit different to the last one, doesn't it? So we'll just,
pop
some lid on just for demonstration purposes. Yep. So we're not going to fix that on in this case. And again, you can see that when that pushes on, those nibs lock it in place, and it goes with a snap, doesn't it? It really does hold on there,
yeah.
Which is really cool. And again, just making things easier for electricians, all these prefabricated bends. As we've said, we will show you how to do bends that you fabricate yourself. There might be times when you need to do that, but how much easier it is just being able to use these ones that are made for you already. Brilliant. So that's the internal 90. One left. We'll look at the next one now.
So we'll look at the flat 90 now, Joe.
Very good. So again, another change here. So we've now got the lid on the kind of on the side of the trunking here, instead of on the inside or the outside. Very good. And again, it's the same principles as we already looked at, Jake, for installation.
That's right. Slots together nice and easy.
Very good. So we push it inside there, and then the holes line up, and it's just a matter of getting those screws done up. Very good. So that just does up. And before you know it, we've got a fully formed right angle. And what's nice about these right angles as well is the way they've got this kind of chamfer in the middle of it here. So if we lay that down flat again, we've got this kind of part here where you can see that it doesn't go across and then down. You've got this kind of chamfer here, which helps you with your bending radii of your cables that you've got installed there, which is super helpful. And we've seen that feature on all of these right angle bends, which is really good. Excellent. So getting these last screws in now. So one on this side and then one on the other side. And that's our accessory connected up. Very good. So we're doing those screws up. So once again, we'll just pop the lid on just as a demonstration effectively. So there's no need to pin this down in this case because we're just demonstrating how this goes on. And once again, you've got the same principle as before. So the lid just snaps on to the accessory and those nibs go over the lid and hold it in place. Again, super helpful. So what kind of application would we be seeing for this one, Jake?
Yes, so you might see that if you're running trunking down a wall or along a wall and you want to change direction, so perhaps something like that.
Yeah, so if you've got it surface mounted like that, that makes sense. So you come down and turn right and then maybe feed into some other accessories
or a
consumer unit or something. Good stuff. Okay, so that's our three right angle bends. So there we go. We've looked at the three different types of right angle accessory that are available for trunking. What were the name of those three right angle bends, Jake?
So we looked at a flat 90, an internal and an external as well.
Excellent. So we're familiar with those now. We've seen them fitted to the trunking. Couldn't be simpler in fairness. And we'll continue to look at some more trunking accessories in our next video in this series. However, of course, we want to hear from you as we always do. So what are your thoughts and what are your questions on this subject of trunking and in particular trunking accessories? Do you like using them for your trunking or do you think it should be done the old school way by fabricating your own bends and joins every single time? Whatever your thoughts are, whatever your questions are, please leave those in the comments section below and Jake will make sure that he gets back to every single one of those. But as always, the only thing left to say in this video is...
Thank you very much for watching.
This is getting
my line now. I think it's
really not your line.